Welcome to Beyond Measure. First up, we'll use the awesome Make the Cut cutting software to create our card base, card frames, and our image. This is an edited image entitled Christmas Star. I pulled it in with the pixel trace. Now, let's go into basic shapes and choose rectangle. Now we need to size and reposition, making sure that we leave enough border on the edges for our card to include our image. This rectangle will become one of the pieces of our foundation. Doing things like this is very easy in Make the Cut software. You click and drag. This is our desired shape and size, so let's copy and paste and get some duplicates. Okay, so let's grab one of those and make it the size of the inside of our to-be frame. So this needs to actually be the image size. And so let's get a foundation and place our image size inside of that. Now we'll align and space vertically and horizontally. Select all and click on Boolean Join. And then this window pops up. But don't be alarmed, as your image will go away temporarily. We chose BA Difference. Maneuver your pieces around to where they will fit on your mat to best cut with the zing. You will need to cut 4 frames and 2 rectangle bases. 1 frame and 1 rectangle base is out of the glitter cardstock. The other is out of plain. This is the awesome Coordinations Clear Translucent cardstock and the Zing embossing tool. It has 2 choices of width of embossing. Now unscrew the carriage mechanism to remove the blade, and next, place your embossing tool with 2 CDs underneath, tighten the white screw, and you're good to go, guys and dolls. Let's get to embossing. To make my normal mat into an embossing mat, I placed some shelf liner on it with blue painter's tape. Once I was finished embossing, I replaced the embossing tool with the blade to cut out the foundation and frames of my card. And this is clear acrylic from Oriental Trading. It's really super to work with. I'm cutting this to be a little larger than my image. You will need to cut 3 of these in all. 2, one for each side of the image to protect it, and 1 for the easel mechanism. You can use score tape, tacky tape, terrifically tacky tape, sticky strip, or this double-sided tape from Oriental Trading. It is my understanding that if you do not want to have to use scissors to cut, then you'll have to use score tape because it tears with your fingers. Trim around the image a bit. Go around the edge of your sparkle frame with the gold metallic marker by Sharpie. It does a super beautiful job, and you really don't have to have much of a steady hand either. Next, we'll emboss in the Sizzix embossing folder entitled Starry Night, and this is the Texture Boutique embossing machine by Sizzix. The frame is a bit bigger than the folder, so I had to just emboss a little bit of it and come back so it didn't flatten it by going through the machine to be able to emboss the entire thing. Now we're going to adhere the acrylic to the other side of our image. This time, you'll use your Tim Holtz tonic scissors to trim very nicely around the acetate acrylic and the image. Oh my goodness, now we get to adhere the sparkle embossed frame to our image. A little bit of a word of caution, try your best not to get fingerprints on the acrylic, or fuzz, fur, or glitter for that matter. My embossing was a little bit deep here, so I'm having to repair it a little bit with my Zig 2-way glue pen. And now I'm just trimming up to make sure it will fit very nicely within the boundaries of my frame. Apply the double-sided sticky tape from Oriental Trading on your frame that will go on the back of your image. Tape side up and apply. As you see, I'm tracing around the frame so that I can cut one more piece of acrylic. But that is only 3 in all, as I had shared previously. My goodness, we get to use some more of the double-sided tape, and we're going to encapsulate or frame our piece of acrylic between two frames with the sticky tape. And now, to create the easel, find the center and score. It is a bit different scoring on acrylic, but it does work. Fold and crease with your bone folder. Now we'll need to cut a 1-inch piece of card the length of our foundation. Then score at half an inch down the center and fold and crease with your bone folder. Next, apply adhesive with the Scotch ATG gun. This sparkle foundation will go on one side. And the easel that we created will go on the other side, so it's as if we created a hinge. Next, you'll want to edge your sparkle cardstock with the Sharpie gold metallic marker. Now we're going to create our sentiment in Make the Cut software using Edwardian script. I typed in the sentiment. As you type, it will come up on your mat in the font in which you chose. You bring it all in at once. To be able to move around the individual words, you must click on Break. And at this point, you can move each individual letter, number, shape, whatever. But I like to be able to manipulate each individual word as one unit. So once you break, you select the word and click Join. I desire for three of the words to have uppercase letters. So I just opened up the text box and typed in the letters in which I needed. I broke apart the word, deleting the first letter, and joined it again. Then manipulate and place to your heart's content with your uppercase letters and lowercase words. I initially chose this tag, but found that I needed a bit more space, so I created a shadow and used it for my sentiment. Then I created a little teeny shadow of that, times two, one out of gold and one out of just scrap piece of black. This is the uber awesome Click and Cut Zing pen tool. You can use virtually any pen or marker. I use the Jelly Rose Shadow by Sakura Pens. They are such high quality. I just ran the sentiment labels through the Xyron 900 Create a Sticker Machine. I use this when I need to be reassured that I will have edge-to-edge adherence. Now we'll use the Sharpie to go around the outer edge of the gold cardstock brayer, and let's punch some holes with our We Are Memory Keepers Big Bite. In those holes, we will place antique brass or antique gold little brads. Now it's time to place adhesive with our ATG gun by Scotch on the other card foundation and place underneath. Oh my goodness, this is so exciting! We're almost there. Now, this is the Scrap Happy Sheer Glue, and you only adhere along the frame. I believe you'll see why we only adhere around the frame in a moment. This is a great time to use clothespins or paper clips to hold together the area in which you used your liquid glue. And this is our completed project. To illuminate, place two battery-operated tea lights behind your card. May the wonderment of his star touch your heart eternally. Be blessed beyond measure.